A vaccine for COVID-19 could soon be available in the US. Over the next few months, there might even be several that get authorized for public use. COVID-19 vaccines are expected to be an important tool to help end the pandemic. If a large portion of the population gets vaccinated, the coronavirus will not be able to spread to new people and will then die down. Pandemic over. So, how does our society figure out who gets them first? Here in the US, federal and state governments are coordinating on vaccine distribution, and they're considering the ethics and logistics that will go into giving out COVID-19 vaccines. The main guidance will come from a federal independent advisory group to the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention called the Advisory Committee on Immunization Practices. This group will make recommendations for each authorized vaccine on dosage, on schedule, on priority groups, as they have for over 50 years. Their stated goal is to use COVID-19 vaccines to reduce severe illness and death from the disease and to minimize disruptions to society and the economy, which basically means keeping our food, healthcare, and transport systems up and running. That might sound pretty clear, but there are a lot of considerations within that goal. For instance, if preventing deaths is most important, it might make sense to vaccinate older people, especially those in nursing homes, first. Their bodies are less likely to fight off the virus successfully. 40% of coronavirus deaths in the US come from long-term care facilities, such as nursing homes and assisted living. And preventing those deaths also means vaccinating healthcare workers in these facilities and elsewhere. There's consensus that these two groups should get the vaccine the soonest. Healthcare workers include all people who make it possible to care for COVID patients and could get exposed in the process, from doctors and nurses to cleaning staff, cafeteria workers, and nursing home aides. Giving healthcare workers and nursing home residents first dibs on vaccines is meant to protect those who have more exposure to the virus because of their jobs, and also those who are more likely to die from the disease. The CDC says healthcare workers are also big influencers on people's health decisions, so the example they set could help convince others down the line to get vaccines. Other high-risk groups like people with kidney and heart disease, or bus drivers and grocery store workers, or people 65 and older, will likely come next. The order in which they will be offered depend on the traits of each product, such as whether they've been tested and proven to work in certain populations. Other big factors include availability and distribution. Another big vulnerable group the CDC is looking to prioritize is low-income and minority communities. They've been more likely to catch the coronavirus and to get very sick or die from it during the pandemic. Health researchers say it's because they're highly represented among essential workers and often live in crowded households. They spend hours in contact with strangers because they can't do their jobs from home. They also face discrimination and poor access to healthcare. Vaccine makers have also taken steps to ensure low-income and minorities will be protected from COVID. They've been recruiting people of different races, ethnicities, and health conditions, so they'll have the data to show whether it's safe and effective in diverse populations. But setting vaccines aside for people is one thing, and getting them into their arms is another. That's a separate set of blueprints that health departments are working out.